How do we maintain our resilience and a calm mind when it looks like everything is going to hell? In this short series of videos, I'm going to showcase for you some techniques and some processes that will help you calm your mind, help you restore a sense of control, and also help support immunity, which is going to be important for you if you're going to weather the more stressful elements of what we're going through with the COVID-19 pandemic. So the first process that I'm going to showcase for you is one in which we help regulate our nervous system and also ensure that what we're doing is we're sending signals of safety back into our neurophysiology. And what I mean by that is our nervous system and how our nervous system then runs our physiology or our body. There's a particular nerve called the vagus nerve, and the vagus nerve is a very important nerve when it comes to health and well-being, our sense of resilience, and also whether we move into fight, flight, or freeze. So the vagus nerve is actually a nerve that we need to maintain the tonicity of, or the nerve strength and tone. So one of the best ways we can do that is to bring ourselves back to our breathing. And I'm going to introduce you to vagus nerve breathing. And what that is a simple process of breathing in over 4 seconds and then out over 8. Now, the maths don't add up, and I know that doesn't make sense, but if you breathe in over 4, in 2, 3, 4, and then out over 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then what that does is it helps balance carbon dioxide levels, but it also sends a signal through the vagus nerve back to your brain that you're safe. And what it does is that feeling of safety helps re-engage what we call the social engagement system, our ability to be able to connect with others, to feel safe, to rest, and also to digest. So it's a type of break for our nervous system, but it's a nice relaxation break, as opposed to the freeze, which is a break in which we are worried about the threat to life, where we just freeze or go into a type of shock. So we want to also stay out of activation of fight or flight. So fight or flight are activated states, and we're seeing a lot of people who are very activated, and we want to make sure that we're not buying into that too much. And also we need to make sure we leave ourselves with a calm sense of presence, because what we're seeing here is a lot of people who are experiencing that fight or flight, a fear of what is yet to come, perhaps. But with all the news that's coming through, they're being inundated with lots of negative information. So the breathing process of 4 seconds in, 8 seconds out is really important. Now, the reason why it's important is the 4 seconds in should be always done through the nose. So always make sure you breathe in through the nose. So in, and then out through the mouth. The exhale actually stimulates the vagus nerve to release a neurotransmitter that helps you to manage your heart rate, to manage all of that digestive stuff that's going on for you, where you might feel tight in the gut or butterflies in the gut. And so it's really important that we make sure that we emphasize the exhale. If you can't do the 4 seconds in, 8 seconds out, I'm going to invite you to do 6 seconds in and 6 seconds out. And from that perspective, you're still regulating your breathing and you're still regulating your vagus nerve. I can't express this enough. The vagus nerve is the key to helping you manage your emotional state, bringing you to a sense of calm, feeling as if you've got a locus of control or a sense of control that is within you, and also will help support your immunity over the long term. So breathing is one of the first, easiest and most manageable elements of things that you can do on a daily basis, no matter where you are, no matter who you're with, and no matter what's happening. Always remember to breathe. So remember the 4, 8, 4 in, 8 out. The next process I'd like to take you through is one that will help you to behaviorally shift the way that you're thinking or feeling. The fastest way to change the way you think or feel is to change the way that you behave. So this is a very behavioral process, and what it'll help you do is to focus on some key things that we actually naturally do, but to do it with a sense of intent and also with purpose. So the first one is our eyes. When we get stressed, when we start to get an experience of fear, or if we feel like we're in conflict with people, usually what happens is our sense of vision, our vision actually starts to tunnel and we start to fixate. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to do a little exercise here where I'd like you to focus on a spot and then just soften your vision. Just place your gaze on it and soften your vision. I'm doing it now. Just allow yourself to take in more and more of the space that you're looking at. And peripheral vision is up and also down. Now, if you want to help yourself, you just put your hands out in front of you, just wriggle your fingers and allow yourself to just notice when your eyes can no longer pick up where your fingers are wriggling, if you want to get a sense of where the peripheral vision is. So that's about the limit of it. It's about 180 degrees for me. But just by training yourself to go from what we call foveal or focused vision on a spot to softening your gaze and just relaxing it, you may find that you start to experience a sense of peace and calm. And usually what you'll find is that sense of peace and calm is what we consider to be an alpha state, or a sense of relaxation as your brain waves start to change. But also what you'll start to feel is a potential sense of getting some distance from your thoughts. Some people notice that the internal dialogue starts to actually switch off. Now, for some people, they're doing their heads in, talking about stuff inside their heads about all the possible things that may happen that haven't yet happened. And so that's part of the structure of anxiety, thinking about what if, creating pictures and sounds and sensations about a future event that hasn't yet happened, and often the catastrophic thinking that goes on with that. So in order to shut the internal dialogue up, what I'm going to invite you to do is to play around with putting your tongue just behind the teeth and just gently on the roof of the mouth, like so. And it should be relaxed, just let it rest there. And what I'm going to invite you to do is to just do that for about 10 to 15 seconds, just let it rest there. Now, if you start to hear any internal dialogue at all, what I'm going to encourage you to do is to create a type of internal static. So the internal static is just shh. Now, it's important that you do that inside your mind, or you can connect that with your breathing, but just inside your mind from the perspective that you'll just go shh, but on the inside, to create internal static in the auditory channel where that voice that you're listening to is playing out. And so what I'm going to encourage you to do is to do that and to practice that and get a sense of whether that works for you. When you've done the wide open peripheral vision, the tongue on the roof of the mouth, and the internal static as separate activities, what I'm going to encourage you to do is to connect all three. Go wide open peripheral vision, tongue on the roof of the mouth, and then just go quiet on the inside. And if you hear any internal dialogue, just shh. The final three things here, just wide open peripheral vision, tongue on the roof of the mouth, shh on the inside, and just sit in that for a little bit. And the more you train that in, the easier it'll be for you to just drop into that nice sense of relaxation. And so that's the second process. The third process is a video that I've linked to YouTube. I'm going to invite you to go to YouTube and listen to the self-hypnosis audio that I've got there. That self-hypnosis audio is 37 minutes long. Make sure you listen to it in a place that is not your bed. So I recommend that you don't listen to it in bed. Get yourself trained into what it's like to go into a state of self-hypnosis. 37 minutes, listen to it through headphones. Listen to it, allow it to wash over you. There's nothing you need to do or have to do. Just allow it to just happen. And as you train your mind and your body to relax, it'll be easier to maintain that sense of peace and calm that you're looking for when everyone else is losing their tiny little minds. Now, just remember that we're all going to pull through this together, and only by connecting through to our social engagement system and maintaining our sense of peace and calm in the presence of others can we then build this sense of community and to make sure that we're all looking after each other, even though we are facing what is an unprecedented event in our lifetimes. So I'm going to continue to maintain some videos and upload them. I'm going to continue to put some news out. So please make sure that you subscribe to the Facebook page, Paul Mischel, or The Corporate Warrior. I'm going to continue to do what I can to support my community, which is you, to work your way through this. We all have the skills and the capabilities to be able to help each other. And for those of us who have the skills and the capabilities to be of service to the community by sharing important, relevant, useful, and also, most importantly, safe information that allows people to be able to manage themselves through this particular situation, then I invite all of those people that have trained with me who have those skills, who work in the allied health professions, to do so as well. Share this information widely, help our community, and help people to be able to manage themselves through what is an unprecedented situation. So together we will get through this, and stay well.